got home late tonight, and I was taking Rocky for his walk about 20 minutes ago, so around midnight. This was near the set of Marble Hornets. A little bit farther down the road, we saw this really tall guy standing in the middle of the street, just completely still. For whatever reason, this really set off Rocky, and he got really scared. He wouldn't move, and he kept on pulling on his leash to go back home. There was something about this guy that was just, it was strange. So we headed back home. I have a little bit of time left on this tape, and I'm going to go see if he's still hanging around. In fact, I think this is the light that he was standing under. So I'm going to have a look here. Okay, you can't really see it well on the camera, but I don't see anyone around here, so I guess he's moved on. But yeah, there's just something about that.
All right, it's recording.
Okay.
this is the gazebo where I want Brian to come back and reflect. Later in the movie, this will probably be about three-fourths of the way through.
This will just be by himself, right?
Yeah. I'm thinking about maybe putting it in. Reflect and decide to actually go back to Sarah, try to win her back. And we got a good number of shots here. We have the stream down there.
Yeah, I like this area. It's very, I don't know, secluded, I guess. All right.
This is going to be near Sarah's hunting camp. Over there is where we're going to do the bonfire scene. Over by the fire pit.
Yeah.
I also want to have a shot of the next day where Sarah and Brian, I might also have Tim there at some point. Are sitting around thinking about the past, talking about days gone by. I really like this place since we have the tree line that basically blocks off our entire shooting area. And we also have these really tall trees right in the middle, which personally I just think are really cool.
What's that tall red thing over there?
Yeah, that's like an old climbing wall, or I can't remember if it was a climbing wall or if the fire department. Although I wish that tall grass were all level, or we had more of it, just kind of abruptly stops over there.
Yeah.
But I'm sure we can work a way around it. Let's start again.
To look at you.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
All right, I'm rolling, and just a second with me.
I thought you were talking to her.
Oh, crap, I just lost this script. Now I'm talking to Brian. Yeah, don't say anything, because the camera picks it up. All right, you ready?
Yeah. Are you going to feed me Tim's lines?
Yeah, just a second. All right. Action.
I don't know. This town just doesn't feel the same to me anymore. I missed it so much when I was in college. But now that I'm back, I just feel like a depressed teenager all over again. Stuck in a loop of unhappiness.
Maybe you've grown up.
I don't know. Maybe this town has grown up.
Maybe it has. Alright, good.
Are we gonna do it again? Are we?
No, we're done.
That's it?
Yeah, we're done.
Okay.
Seemed really distant ever since he came back, you know?
And?
I mean, have you talked to him at all?
No.
Well, did he come back because of you? Because he never told me why he was here.
Doesn't really matter, does it? He left me when he went off to the city, and that's that.
Yeah, I guess you're right. So, I mean, what's the plan now for you? What's next?
I'm not really gonna do anything.
We're gonna do it again. The pacing still feels weird. It doesn't sound like a conversation. You guys still sound like you're reading off of the script. Let's just have a conversation. Let's do it again.
Still, he takes. Still. Can we go yet?
Action. Well, no, we can't. One second.
That's, yeah, wonderful.
That's what happens when you come out of public place.
Good thing I didn't have anything to do later today,
yeah,
you know.
I know. 12 to 1.
Why would you have anything to do anyway? You knew you were coming on set. You knew this could take a while.
Yeah, it was supposed to be an afternoon shoot, though.
You guys would do it right. First,
it was afternoon shoot. I didn't even buy lunch.
Let's just do it again.
Just stop.
Alright.
Action.
He seemed really distant ever since he came back, you know?
From the beginning.
Rolling.
What? Roll. Did you not have it recording during the break? I told you to keep the camera recording at all times. Oh. How long was it off?
I forgot for a second.
You forgot. I gave you one job. All you're supposed to do is come in here, set up the camera, make sure it doesn't fall over, and press record once. You don't stop it at all. I made this extremely clear.
If this is going to go on for a while, can I get a script again?
You helped me load up the car. You know how many tapes we have. If we run out of time on this tape, we'll get another. It's not a problem. I mean, how clear do I have to make it before you listen? I mean, get off. You brought your dog. How many sets is that? Memorize your lines.
It's just a mistake.
Memorize your lines. Maybe we'll get through this a little bit faster.
Memorize your lines. Just don't read them right off the page. You gotta be a little bit more human with it.
Because
don't
I've
be
had
so...
the script in every scene.
Exactly.
Yeah, you know, act. How about that?
Oh yeah, that's real nice, you know, considering how much you're paying us and everything.
Why would I pay you for what you're giving me? I mean, really.
Oh, that's real nice.
Who else is gonna work with you with this attitude?
Look.
Yeah, you already spent so much money on tapes, you can't afford actors anyway.
Let's just get it done with, alright? Let's just get it done. I'm sorry. Just don't stop recording. It's not a problem. Plenty of tapes.
Okay, fine. Sorry.
Hilmer. Let's go ahead and get this shot. It's so okay. Hot. As long as we have the camera shot, just get Seth to control it, and we'll be out of here in no time.
Are we doing live?
Not in this part. We're okay. Just walking to the river, and that's when you guys will start picking up.
Okay.
So, just follow us as we cross into the frame.
All right.
I hope so. And that's about as far as we're going to go. We don't want to touch. That would be gross.
Oh, here's Tim.
Let's get him off the set. I hope he's not angry at it. Hey, buddy.
What's he doing?
Yeah, this one's kind of low.
Do you have the extra one?
No, I think I left it in the car. Can you go get it?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, wait, where is it?
I think I left it in the passenger seat.
Okay.
If not, the trunk.
All right.
I'm going to keep on going, though, so just... Okay. Thank you.
Hey, Tim.
Oh, hey. Jay, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
You ready to do your screen test for this?
I guess so. I mean, it's been quite a while, so you kind of get me up to speed, but...
Yeah, that's fine. I can do that. Set the camera down here. So here's the script for the screen test.
Okay.
And I'll just be taking some notes.
All right. Can I write on this, or...?
Yeah, that's fine.
Okay.
It's yours. You can have it. Before we do the screen test, I wanted to ask you a few things about the production before now, you know.
Just, like, locations or something? Because I think I remember there was a couple around here, but...
More specifically, the director, Alex. Alex Crayley, if you remember him.
I don't really remember much. I mean, he was a friend of Brian's, so I didn't really talk to him that much. I mean, he just kind of asked me to be part of the cast for the sake of convenience.
Right, okay. Did you live near him?
Relatively speaking,
I mean, he kind of lived in the middle of nowhere, right?
Well, I mean, I live next to Brian, so, I mean, I didn't really live near Alex. He was just kind of off.
Okay, in terms of his directing at the time, how was he as a director?
He was a pretty decent director, well, at first.
At first?
Yeah, I mean, after a while, he got to the point where, yeah, I mean, it seemed like after a while he got to the point where he would be yelling at us more than he'd be actually be filming the movie, so and he'd just be really paranoid, waving his camera around all over the place. I mean, I just couldn't really...
His camera, other than the camera he was using to shoot the...
Yeah, he had a handheld that he was carrying around with him all over the place.
Okay.
And a ton of tapes, too, like...
Right, he had all
bags
the tapes
of and... tapes in the back of his car.
How many would you say you had?
Way more than necessary.
More than you would need to make a production like this?
Yeah.
Just for himself?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay. So, like, it's like more than, like, 15 or 20? Okay. All right. Speaking of Alex, I mean, I don't know if you knew this or not, but he did move away after he ended this production. Do you know what might have caused him to do that, or even where he might have gone to?
I didn't even know he moved away. I mean, obviously, like I said, Brian's the one that was really friends with him. I'm just kind of... was along for the ride, but...
Do you happen to know where Brian is?
I haven't heard from Brian either.
Okay.
Not for quite a while, actually.
Okay. So you wouldn't know what might have caused Alex to move away?
No. I know Brian did say something about, like, I think somebody was leaving dead animals in, like, his front yard or something. But,
like pets, or... Do you really know?
What do you mean, pets? Like,
like cats or dogs or anything?
I don't think so.
Because, I mean, he did kind of live in a heavily wooded area.
I don't think it was anything like that, but, I mean, you have to ask Brian.
Okay. More about the set of Marble Hornets. Was there anything... I know that you know, most of the places that you filmed this, I mean, there were some indoor, some, like, interior scenes, but most of it was exterior, like, in the woods, right?
Yeah. I mean, okay. It was, like, parks... And some was just kind of like off in the woods.
Right. I mean, Alex did take me location scouting with him a few times. So
yeah.
I did see a few of the places he was thinking about. But did you happen to notice, I know these are like public places and there were people there, but did you notice anything out of the ordinary about any people, anyone that you saw?
No, I mean, it was just, you know, families, kids, you know, just, I mean, you just have to get people off the set on a regular basis, so.
Okay. Anyone that you wouldn't assume would be in a place like that, like a park or anything, like guy in a business suit, like a black business suit.
Don't remember. I mean, it was quite a while ago, and then there may have been, but I mean, it's, you know, several years ago, and you're asking me about a guy in a suit, so.
Okay, so you don't really remember
no.
any specifics about anyone you had to move off the camera?
No, I mean, it just, you know, nothing out of the ordinary.
Okay. I was just wondering, since you know I have the raw footage of the tapes, and but
yeah. I'm really sorry, but I gotta get to lunch after this. Can we
right, I mean, yeah, okay, that's fine. I'm sorry. We can do this.
Okay.
I can't forget the camera set up.
I had to do that about 5 times.
That's a good story.
Mm.
Jay, if you want to just stand where Brian's going to be and read his lines for me.
Yeah, I got the script here.
All right.
Am I out of the frame?
Yeah, you're good. You know where we're starting, Tim?
Why'd you come back?
Yes.
All right.
And just whenever you're ready.
All right. So why'd you come back?
I had to.
Was it because of Sarah?
I thought I'd be able to leave her behind along with the rest of this town, but I just can't seem to get her out of my head.
I thought you said you were over her.
I thought so, too.
That's far enough.
Okay.
Yeah, let's not do too much.
Who wrote that dialogue with you, Alex?
That was just me.
Okay.
I do all the script for this. Do you know where Brian is?
I think he said he was just running down to the store for some snacks or something. He should be back in a minute.
Okay.
Can I get some water or something?
Yeah. Is this one yours?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thanks.
No problem.
Why are you wearing a jacket?
It's pretty cold in here.
I'm comfortable.
I feel like you have the AC cranked up or something. You left the camera on.
Oh, well, we're going to go through it a couple more times anyway, but...
Hello? Who's here? Alex. No!
Thanks.
No problem.
Why are you wearing a jacket?
It's pretty cold in here.
Alright, let's see, we'll do a little special featurette here for the D&D.
Yeah, since we're waiting for Tim, who's running kind
of late. Flip the screen over for me. That looks awful. Where'd that painting go then?
There we go.
Took it down, now I want it back. There we go.
Yeah, full creative control here.
Not even gonna put it on the hook. Brian has excellent taste in art.
Yeah.
So we're here on the set of Marble Hornets, here at Brian's house. Brian is somewhere. I don't know where.
I wasn't paying attention. Were you?
No. We've been doing some script revisions for coming up here.
I've been supervising that because I'm the script supervisor.
Yes, Jay has been very helpful today. I'm very proud of him. We're just waiting on Tim to get here. Going to give him the new script, maybe run over some lines.
This new script. That's a whole lot of power to give someone like him.
Yeah. You know. Pretty much everyone's at risk. It's a terrifying place. And there's Tim, so. Come on in! How you doing, Tim? Drive all right?
Yeah, it's okay. Sorry I'm late.
No problem?
Jeez. Why is it so cold in June?
Let's go ahead and start over from... I'm tired of this.
Speaking of what, I'm really tired of this. I really need a break now.
take five, I guess.
Take five.
Yeah.
Everything highlighted for him. He's...
I think so. I think I got it all.
Wow.
Is he okay?
Normal. He shouldn't have come if he was sick.
I know.
You alright, Tim? Need anything?
No, I'm okay.
What's that?
Just some medicine I have to take.
Do you need to go home? Should we cut?
No, I'm fine.
Alright.
Seth is gone. I don't remember what happened. we were the only two left. And I left him. Brian is gone. Tim and Jay and Sarah. Everyone is gone. I just woke up in this house with the tape. Seth's camera is gone. All I can remember from the night is right here. All I can remember at all is on the tape now. I'm leaving this house. I thought I would be safer here by running away, but everything's just gotten worse. I'm going back to my home, and I'm burning these tapes. All of them.
Hello?
Thank you. We will wait for you no more. Control is being taken away from you. From the start, it's been a game for us. Not anymore. I'm coming for you, and you will lead me to the Ark.
Firefighters are on the scene of an apartment fire in Chelsea County. Shannon has been covering it for us. She joins us now with the latest. Shannon?
Angie, if you take a look behind me, this is the most relaxed we've seen this scene since we've been here. The original firefighters that were here have all left, and they've all been replaced by firefighters from all over, as from as far away as we've seen some from as well. But the firefighters do think that everyone got out okay except for some pets. A few disabled residents were rescued by the police chief and several other people who ran inside to pull them out. Kim is the name of the police chief who were told rescued about three people on his own. He ran inside this burning building to bring the people out. This is home video that was shot by a resident. At one point, you can see the flames coming out of a side bedroom, and it's believed that's where the fire started on the third floor. A woman heard fire crackling in her bedroom, and she tried to put it out with a towel, but it grew into this large fire. At one point, the roof collapsed, and that was a dangerous situation for firefighters. Once they started putting water on the flames, there was a lot of smoke, so you could definitely smell this fire before you could see it. Fire officials believe that this building is going to be a total loss. There were 12 apartments in this building, and the Red Cross is here to assist the people who have been displaced.
I haven't thought about it in the past week, and frankly, I've been feeling a lot better. My memory's better, I'm not as paranoid, I'm not looking over my shoulder all the time like I used to be. So I think that this is for the best. So this is going to be the last entry that I'll be posting. Thank you.
So when did this happen?
Wait, what happened?
When did we get a camera? Alex, come on.
We don't have a camera.
Yes, we do.
Where did you find that?
It was in the closet. There's a tape already in it, but when I tried to watch it, it was messed up or something. I don't know.
That's probably just my old camera from college. I probably stuck it back in there when we moved. Just gonna sell it.
But I thought we didn't have a camera.
What? Doesn't matter. I'm gonna sell it. Just please put it back. Stop recording.
Fine, I'm not recording anymore.
I can still see the light.
Are you okay, Alex?
I'm fine. Just put it back, please.
You're in a really odd mood right now. Fine.
Right now.
What is that?
Jump out of the street. Get down to the street. Go. I'm going to be right behind you. Go.